The incident that took place in the Galwan River Valley in Ladakh on the night of 15-16 June marks a significant watershed, a paradigm shift, if you will, between the relations between India and China. 15th of June, by the way, happens to be the birthday of the paramount leader of China, Xi Jinping. His Western theater commander, General Zhao Zongqiu, wanted to give a surprise birthday gift to his boss. He therefore ordered this clash on that very night. It was unfortunately a gift that destroyed the peace and tranquility accords that had been signed between India and China in 1993, in 1996, 2005 and 2015. In one fell stroke, the peace and tranquility that had reigned on the India-China border for the last 53 years, ever since the clash in Nathula in 1967, was destroyed forever. It is therefore important for us to examine this incident in some detail. In end April, beginning May, the 6th Mechanized Infantry Division, along with the 4th Highland Motorized Rifle Division of the Xinjiang Military District, which was part of the erstwhile Lanzhou Military Region, now part of the Western Theater Command, was carrying out exercises opposite Ladakh. The 6th Mechanized Infantry Division is the Rapid Reaction Force of the Xinjiang Military District. It has 3 mechanized infantry brigades, 1 armored brigade, along with attack helicopters, tanks and artillery. Suddenly, 1 mechanized brigade each of the 6th Mechanized Division made a dash for the Galwan Valley and the Pongongso Lake 8 Fingers area. Some elements went for the hot spring, and the elements of the 4th Highland Motorized Rifle Division went opposite Depsang and Daulat Bay Goldi. Galwan River Valley, which is incidentally named after Ghulam Rasool Galwan, wrestler of Ladakh, famous wrestler, is vital to China. Why? Because it seems to them to pose a threat to the very vital National Highway Golf 219, the Aksai Chin Road that links Xinjiang with Tibet. The Chinese think it poses a threat. India has recently constructed at great effort and cost the 255-kilometer highway starting from Darbuk, Shyok to Daulat Beg Oldi in the north. This links up the vital subsector north with Leh. From the Shyok Galwan River junction, India had started constructing a feeder road that goes along the Galwan River to Patrol Point 14 on the line of actual control. China viewed this road as a threat to its Aksai Chin Highway and raised serious objections and sent in the 6th Mechanized Division to stall the construction of this road. It is noteworthy that India had at no time objected to the extensive rail and road infrastructure that China has built up in Tibet, because that was on China's own side. But China reacted quite violently to our construction of infrastructure, belated construction of infrastructure, by mobilizing 2 of its divisions and in a very threatening posture. Initial commercial satellite imagery was interpreted by some people to indicate that the Chinese had perhaps come in 3 kilometers inside the LOC to sit on the heights dominating the Darbuk Shyok DBO road, and thereby they had done a Kargil redux. However, subsequent analysis proved this to be highly exaggerated and faulty claim. Alarmed by the very threatening move forward of the Chinese 6th Mechanized and the 4th Highland Motorized Rifle Division, India rapidly mobilized its forces and matched the Chinese soldier for soldier artillery gun for artillery gun and tank for tank. This led to a major standoff and showdown. The Chinese were deeply surprised by this very rapid Indian reaction to China's provocation. The Chinese opted for talks and a disengagement of forces. Accordingly, talks were held at the brigade, the divisional, and finally at the corps commander level on the 6th of June this year. Lieutenant General Harinder Singh, GOC 14 Corps, and Major General Liu Lin, the Xinjiang Military District Commander, they talked on the 6th, had marathon talks on the 6th of June, and it was agreed that both sides would disengage their troops by moving them back 2.5 kilometers and 1.5 kilometers respectively for China and India. However, it was subsequently learned that the Chinese troops had in fact not withdrawn from the Galwan River Valley mouth, and in fact at patrol point 40 they had come in about 100 and 150 meters and they had constructed two tents and a watchtower in our area. From here, they could overlook the entire Galwan River Valley as also the DBO road. The Chinese had constructed a dam on the Galwan River on their side, and possibly this was to stop the flow of water into the narrow gorge of the Galwan on the Indian side and thereby create a way for their tanks and their armored personnel carriers to come into India should they so desire. On 15 June evening, a 10-man patrol of the 16th Bihar was sent forward to check whether the Chinese had gone back or not. They came up to the Nala Bend on the mouth of the Galwan River and they found a Chinese tent. They burnt that tent. As this party was coming back, it was ambushed by a massive armed Chinese force, and they were forcibly taken away. Colonel Santosh Babu, the gallant commanding officer of the 16th Bihar, now went forward himself to check whether the Chinese had indeed gone back. He had moved forward with a Ghatak platoon of about 30 of his best boys. As he was climbing up to patrol point 14, he observed a large number of Chinese in that area. The Chinese asked him to stop. They asked him to come up alone if he wanted to talk. In good faith, Colonel Babu moved up with just two of his boys and he went up to patrol point 14. There was a brief discussion that soon became into a very violent argument, and without warning, the Chinese attacked the CO and his two boys in a very cowardly fashion. They were attacked with sticks fixed with nails, baseball bats wound with barbed wire, iron rods and pointed stones. Colonel Babu and his boys were severely wounded and fell on the spot. His men rushed up to save him. They were enraged when they saw their wounded commanding officer. The boys of the Ghatak platoon fixed their bayonets and charged up that slope. They got into a hand-to-hand fight with a Chinese force that was 10 times theirs in number and size. The Chinese force was very well prepared. They had collected a huge pile of sharp stones which they started showering on these boys as they were climbing up. Regardless of that fusillade of stones, these boys charged up and they got into a hand-to-hand fight with the Chinese. They snapped the necks of a number of Chinese soldiers. But the boys realized that they were badly outnumbered. Their CO was very severely wounded, but he refused to be evacuated and continued to guide the battle. He asked them to fetch up reinforcements. The second in command of 16th Bihar, Colonel Nagpal, then rushed forward with about 80 men of the Bihar regiment to support his CO. As he was charging up, he saw that 400 Chinese had joined the fight. He then asked for reinforcements from the other units close by. The men from the Sikh boys from the 3 medium regiment, the 2nd field artillery regiment, as also 14th Punjab, now their Ghatak platoon, also rushed forward. We had a royal melee going on in this area of patrol point 14 and the Nala Bend now. 250 Indian soldiers were fighting with some 400 plus Chinese soldiers. You know, the Indian soldiers snatched the Chinese barbed wire wound bats and their iron rods, and they hit them with their own weapons. There was Sipahi Gurtej of the 14th Punjab. This boy single-handedly fought with four Chinese soldiers. They were fighting on a narrow ledge. He threw the four of them down, and he also fell quite a few feet down, but his fall was stopped by a rock. Badly wounded, he got up, rewound his turban, took out his small kripan and charged into the Chinese. This boy single-handedly killed 12 Chinese soldiers. It was an amazing feat of raw courage. Sipahi Surinder Singh snatched the club of the Chinese soldiers and used it to deadly effect and caused a number of casualties. The Chinese were shaken by this charge. Battered and bruised, but full of josh, our boys charged at the Chinese. They charged up PP-14, they burnt down their tent, and they demolished that watchtower which had been constructed. In fact, the boys were so full of rage that they chased the frightened Chinese down into that Nala Bend. There they found that the Chinese had constructed a dam across the Galwan River to stop its flow to the Indian side. The boys jumped into the freezing cold Galwan River, and with their bare hands they tore that dam down to restore the water. Some of the boys died of hypothermia in the extreme cold, but they did not stop before their mission was reached. In fact, they had entered deep into enemy territory, and they had chased the 400 the Chinese soldiers, who had most of them dropped their bats and fled. You see, the Chinese had suffered 16 killed in the first charge of the Ghatak platoon of 16 Bihar itself. On the following day, our soldiers counted 46 stretchers being taken away, possibly of the dead. The number of wounded was far higher. Helicopter sortie after helicopter sortie was seen evacuating the Chinese from there. A field hospital had to be set up by them to give emergency treatment to the people on the spot. Two Chinese Mercedes cars with their very senior commanders had come up to take stock of the carnage. The CIA has estimated that the total number of Chinese dead was 35. The Indians had suffered one colonel and 19 boys killed. This action highlights the very significant role that a commanding officer plays in the life of a unit. Seeing their commanding officer mortally wounded, the boys turned into tigers to avenge their CO's death. They fought with fearful odds, but thanks to the brave hearts of Bihar and Punjab and the artillery, the honor of our nation was safeguarded that night. In fact, the whole world was shaken by the raw fury and sheer gallantry displayed by our boys in such a cruel hand-to-hand medieval engagement. We gave much better than we got, and China, which was trying to bully India, was taught a bitter lesson that shook up the PLA and watered down its truculence. Ladies and gentlemen, this then is the saga of the brave hearts of Galwan. In one night of fury, they faced overwhelming odds. Finally, 250 Indian soldiers fought with 400 plus Chinese. But they gave such a terrific account of themselves. They fought like the lions and tigers that they were. Bound hand and foot by the treaties of peace and tranquility, which forbade them from using their firearms, they had to fight with their bare hands. It is of men such as these that it is said, "Thus spoke brave Horatio, the captain of the gate, to every man upon this earth, death cometh soon or late. But how can a man die better that facing fearful odds for the ashes of his fathers, for the temples of his gods.